Hi. So yes, as the title of the video suggests, I did get a job this Friday as a tutor in Champions Learning Center. I'm really happy that I got a job. It pays $15 per hour. I just have to get fingerprinted on Monday, and then after that, I'll get linked to students to tutor. I don't want to be too technical with what the program does, but the Champions Learning Center is a federally funded program funded by No Child Left Behind Act, in which schools are designated as need schools. You know, those schools that, you know, in which the students are not performing well on their tests. They get categorized as need schools, and those need schools are then eligible or qualified to receive support from institutions like Champions Learning Center. And then Champions Learning Center will offer free tutoring services to the students. Every student is eligible for each year 30 sessions of tutoring for free. So that's pretty much what I've been hired for. I haven't started yet. I need to get fingerprinted by New York Department of Education, and I'll do that this Monday. So I got a job, and I'm really, really kind of glad for that, but at the same time, I'm not that happy. You know, I'm not happy at the fact that I got the job, but I'm not happy because that same day that I got the job, I got an email from one of the positions I applied for, which was Lyft hyphen the Bronx. So Lyft is an acronym for the organization, and they got sites all over the country, and one of the sites, the only site they have in New York, is at the Bronx. Hence the name Lyft the Bronx, which is really cool. I mean, just as a sentence of the Bronx, it's a organization that helps people in poverty living in the Bronx area. It refers people to different services that they're eligible for: job training, food stamps, health like primary care physician, anyone that is eligible and just needs to kind of rise up out of the low income poverty level that they are. This is the kind of the organization that helped them. And I applied for there as an AmeriCorps applicant. I got an email back from them on that Friday that I got hired for Champion Learning Center. And the email told me that I wasn't accepted as the site coordinator is a position I applied for. And they have two site coordinators there already. I would have been the third site coordinator focusing on resource management and just kind of being in charge or, you know, being really responsible for resources that are for the community, just kind of organizing them, the organization trains volunteers, recruits volunteers, and just kind of supervising volunteers and how they offer services to people. And I was really looking forward to that position, and I was kind of looking forward to maybe having the tutoring job as a second part-time job I do in the weekends or something, because this Bronx job really doesn't pay well. I was telling my friend about like the compensation, and I'm fine with the compensation if not for the fact that I don't have to pay back my college loans. But if I didn't have college loans, it'd be perfect. The salary is perfect for me. I could live on that. But the compensation it offers is $12,000 a year, that's like a living stipend. And then added on to that is $200 per month that the agency offers. So in total, it's about $14,000, and it gives you health benefits. I believe it reimburses you for travel. It might not actually, and it gives you food stamps. So on that alone, like that, I'm totally fine with that. My living expenses without loans, I could live on $10,000 a year if I have to, because my monthly expenses, if I don't buy anything miscellaneous like a video game or something, it's $900 a month. I can live on that because I'm vegan and I really buy cheap produce. Organic produce I started buying last week. They weren't really that expensive actually at this one place I know. So I don't really spend too much money, so I could do that definitely. And for that, my career as a social worker would really be amazing to have that job. It'd be really career building. So I was severely disappointed when I learned that I didn't get it. This tutoring job pays a lot more. It is $15 an hour, which is definitely a lot more. If I do 40 hours a week, you know, that's way more than freaking $14,000 a year, which is Which is almost volunteer salary. That's like almost working for pretty much almost nothing, which I was fine with. I mean, that organization just sounded so awesome. I would have so loved to have worked there, but I do this vlog, vlog, because not getting hired and then getting hired, just like, it doesn't put me in a dilemma, but it really makes me think about my future ahead. I took a 4-year college as a social work major, and now I'm just kind of at a crossroads. Like, if I start tutoring, and I love tutoring, I've done that so much in my life. You know, I have a lot of experience tutoring, in the 1-on-1, and this is exactly what that job entails. Going to people's houses and with the parent guardian watching over me tutoring them. I mean, that's you know, I have no problem with that. I tend to, I think I'm pretty confident in doing that too. I think I'm pretty good at tutoring too. So the job itself doesn't bother me. What bothers me is that my career might have to shift. I mean, all this time I've been kind of thinking myself as a aspiring social worker and being a social worker, but my Bronx application didn't fall through, and I'm gonna start tutoring as a job, and then I'm still waiting on the application to New York City Teaching Fellows. And if that falls through, now I have to think, what am I gonna do with my life, kind of thing. It's this, I always thought I knew what I was gonna do, you know, kind of graduate with a bachelor's in social work, and then after that, maybe find a job in nonprofit, maybe anything in nonprofit, like administrative assistant, even a desk, like just a regular receptionist, or, but I was really hoping for something like case manager or site coordinator, you know, or an intern, maybe. I don't know, anything in a nonprofit. But if I don't get anything in nonprofit, and then I get accepted into, and this is a big if, I'm kind of not sure that I would get accepted into the New York City Teaching Fellows, just because my teaching sample during the interview wasn't done that well. I really did well in the interview, the one-on-one personal interview, but the group things I didn't really do well. And if I was the evaluator, if I was the selector, I don't know if I would choose to pick me for the program. But in any case, if that does happen, if I do get picked for New York City Teaching Fellows, I mean, I think I'm gonna pursue it. I think I'm gonna become a special education teacher. And special education teacher is still, you know, it's still doing what I love doing, but it's no longer social work. And that just made me think, like, would I be willing to do that? Would I be willing to shift career at this point? I'm still young, so perhaps after years and years of doing special education or something, maybe I could still go back to social work, get a master's in social work, and be a social worker, or try to be a school social worker or something. But it's still like the I still have to kind of transition to shift careers, and that just kind of worries me. And something I don't really want to think about at this point. I'm kind of scared of thinking about it, actually. But that's what's happened, you know. I've been all this time, you know, I've been wanting a job to get something that pays, and finally it happens. And it's surprising how life works, 'cause I'm not that happy about it, you know. I want to be happy. I want to be glad, but it's, you know, it's what it is, I guess. Although I am definitely excited to be tutoring. It is what I love doing, and it is, I think, one of my greatest skills is tutoring. You know, I think I'm pretty good at tutoring. Not to be arrogant or anything, but I mean, I think that's true about me. And I met a cool friend through this interview process. One of the candidates, we both got hired, you know, and she just recently came to America from Canada, and so she was just struggling around trying to find her, you know, find her way around the subway system and stuff. So I helped her out, and now she's you know, I think she'd be a good friend that could hang out with and stuff. So yeah, so definitely, I think good things are gonna come out of this new job opportunity, but it's just that thought lingers in my head, you know, like, this isn't gonna be, if this will this become my permanent thing, you know, will education be my career now and not social work? And it's a very difficult thought process for me to deal with.